Last time on Get Set Build, we looked at a variable controlled slider, much like this one. Sam has decided to come over and look at what we're doing today. Let's see what would happen if we looked away for a second. Our machine's maxed out. And it does not seem to be working. Except I'm pretty sure my machine is still working. I suspect foul play. Let's use our applicator tool to check the variable and see what happened. Sure enough, when we looked away, Sam hit the button 150 times. Sam, why do you do these things? Now we're gonna have to hit our decrease increment button 150 times to get back to zero again. There must be a better way. And of course there is. In this version of our slider gate, we still have the buttons attached to the increment value, attached to the value going to our slider. However, we've added two gates to each side of our mechanism. Now our variable travels into a greater and less than gate, which then travels up to a pair of AND gates. If the conditions of the greater than or less than gates are not met, the AND gates will terminate our button's ability to send a signal. Right now, you can see that the condition is met in order to increase the value of our slider because the wire is glowing. If we were to hit our button now, our slider will move upward. But now, we've hit the max of our limit, and you can see the wire has turned off, and we are no longer able to affect the slider, even though there's another position open for it to move into. This is because we've set the slider's max at one position lower than the maximum distance the slider will allow. And of course, we've done the same for the other side, which is now glowing. And now, we can decrease. Whenever these buttons are allowed to be hit, the AND gate will let the signal through. Otherwise, it will prevent the signal from passing through. And this will stop Sam's tomfoolery. Another way to solve this problem is with a siphon solution, which I like to think of as the Pythagoras' greedy cup method. This time, we have a single button for increasing the value of our slider. Instead of having a decrease button, we now run our variable through a greater than gate, which goes into a set gate, which turns our variable to zero, any time that the variable goes outside of the range of the greater than gate. Now, when we attempt to go beyond the top of the slider resets. Using range limiters like these should help prevent your variables from getting out of hand. See you next time on Get Set Builds.